Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Today we have with us Subir Ghosh, who's written the book The Grand Illusion regarding the GSPC and the publisher of the book Paranjoy, Guha, Thakurta. Subir, what made you write this book? Because this is the GSPC issue has been around, but nobody has really done a detailed analysis that you have.
No, as a journalist, you end up doing all kinds of stories. As a journalist, I mean as a reporter. You can do those he said, she said kind of a very elementary reportage. Or you can probably report about an incident, an accident, a fire or something like that. No, these are kind of happenstances. Now, there are other things that we call developing stories. A developing story can develop, say, over a period of 2-3 days. It can develop a political development. It can be spread over, say, maybe 1-2 months. Now, there are lots of other stories also which develop over, say, 5-10 years. This story developed over 15 years. Now, as a journalist, you have lots of circumstantial reporting to do. As a journalist, you also have the duty to paint the bigger picture as and when you can and as and when you actually need to do it. Now, this was something that had been crossing our minds when we were working on our earlier collaboration, which was Gas Wars. Now, if you remember, GSPC would keep on cropping up once in a while, almost in the background. Now, GSPC came on its own in the foreground a few years back after the two CAG reports. One was in 2012, the other was in 2016. That's when it came to the fore, all on its own. And that's when we actually had been talking about it, that it probably merits a bigger canvas rather than writing a 500-word article here or maybe a 1200 article somewhere else. It doesn't really make sense because it doesn't really tell the ordinary person the big story, or it doesn't actually paint the bigger picture. So that's when we decided, it probably needs to take the form of a book, because this is something that has happened over 15 years, starting from from the Gujarat riots of 2002.
15 years, and as you put it in the book, 20,000 crores. Now that takes a lot of time and, shall we say, mechanisms to really spend this amount of money. In your book, you talk about 20,000 crores having spent, but no gas having come out of it for 12 years. So how does the government justify this at all, the Gujarat government? And the CAG is the one which has actually castigated in very sharp terms.
The government has been justifying it in only one way, that is that expenditure has been done. And the gas will be recovered very soon. And there are lots of geological complexities which become a hindrance in terms of extracting gas to the point that has been probably been projected, plain and simple. Now, that has not happened. Now, what has happened is very interesting. GSPC actually predates the Modi era by about 20 odd years. It was established in 1979. Now, it was taken up by the Gujarat government after 2003. It was taken up as a showcase of the, which later on became the Gujarat Model. Now, this was a company that never made any losses. It was never really running in the red. It was just another good, healthy, more or less healthy looking PSU at that time. Now, after the NELP, which was the new exploration licensing policy of the government, where the government from 1998 onwards, I think, invited private players to explore oil and gas in the country.
This is about giving out the oil and gas blocks to private parties.
Yes, that was when GSPC actually decided to. Earlier it was called the Petroleum Corporation. Now, it ventured into oil and gas exploration activities quite on its own. This predates Modi's time. Check out the archives, you will see it was a very staid looking company, but it did not make any pompous statements, any kind of vainglorious assertions or anything like that. It was just a very staid company saying that we are going to go into oil and gas exploration with respect to the Indian government's changed policy. Till then, it was all fine. Now, after you know, you should read the book. This is the kind of pegging, you know, pitching the book also, that you should read how the Gujarat government actually did little bit of jugglery, little bit of creative accounting, and then they inflated the, you know, the net worth of the consortium, which was, you know, which included GSP as the 80% partner. That story aside, after 2003-2005, the Chief Minister of Gujarat in June 2005 made this very big statement, saying that we have made a huge discovery and it's worth so many billions of dollars, and with this we are going to conquer the world. In short, that is what his statement was. If you delve into kind of historical accounts, I would say, news reports about Modi saying something else altogether later on. If you look at what the ONGC people say, or what the critics say, or the advocates say, there are lots of problems with the terminologies. Now, it's extremely important. That is something that I really kind of discovered, was that the people kept on talking about recoverables. Now, what exactly is a recoverable? In oil and gas parlance, everything is recoverable. So when somebody says that there is so much of gas there and so much percentage of it is recoverable, actually doesn't mean anything. Everything is recoverable. Now, there are proven reserves, also called proved reserves, and there are probable reserves and there are possible reserves. Now, what is the difference between all these three? The only difference is that the percentage, which is actually a probability. So there's a 90% chance, 90% probability that you will get recovered gas. So that's called a proved reserve. Now, a probable reserve, it comes down to 50%, and in terms of possible reserves, it comes down to 10%. That's the only difference. People have been talking in terms of talking. So this is not just a question of semantics. No, it's actually kind of quantifying things, that a proven reserve is something like that's 90%. To an ordinary person, it would be just what is proven and what is probable and what is possible. It is just a question of semantics. Actually, it is not.
In terms of the engineering of it, there are strict definitions, what you are saying. And normally, this kind of sleight of hand is also done by, for instance, big capital, when they want to raise money from the market, which Ambani also did, for instance, with KG Basin Gas. They also used exactly this kind of flim-flam, shall we say, linguistic parlance, by overriding the distinctions and talking of reserves without talking about what is recoverable, what is proven, what is probable, what is possible, and so on. So, shall we say, done for different reasons, but virtually the same kind of flim-flam. So, they seem to have learned this game, and Paranjoy will tell you about it, because he did also the Ambani KG Basin issue.
Yeah, in collaboration with Shubir. And to add to what Shubir has already said, you see, Gujarat State Petroleum Corporation was just one more state government-owned public sector undertaking. It was really in 2005 that it shot into the limelight when the then Chief Minister of Gujarat, Narendra Modi, made these tall claims that the gas that was supposed to be there, which GSPC is supposed to have discovered, would not only make Gujarat energy secure, it would make the whole of the country energy secure. And when that gas was thereafter not found, and then you had this series of questionable deals, including with companies in the Adani group, companies in the Ambani group, you had the controller and auditor general severely castigating the company, then the company started borrowing. And thereafter, what happens, by 2014, Modi has become the Prime Minister of India. And 2 years after he's become the Prime Minister of India, what happens is the public sector undertaking, one of India's biggest public sector corporations, that the ONGC, the Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, decides to literally bail out this company.
Before you go to the bailout, let's see, look at the scale of it, which you have written about. 20,000 crores spent over this period and no gas. That's the sum and substance of the
negligible gas.
Negligible gas. Let me correct myself. Negligible gas. And as we know, in the petroleum sector, it's Any gas, as you said, is recoverable, provided you are willing to spend money. Now, if you have to spend $10 and get $3 out of it, obviously it doesn't make any sense. And what was being fudged was the cost of drilling, the cost of recovery as against the price which they would recover. And therefore, every barrel that you extract, every cubic meter of gas you extract is a loss because you'll have to spend more on it. This is really the, the CAG accounts which finally laid bare the scam, that you are spending money and recovering hardly any gas. And if you spend more money, you will actually run into bigger losses. You're not going to make any profit, let alone much gas. That's the sum and substance of the book.
But you have to also remember two things. There is the 2012 report where the CAG had warned that you are going on the wrong track because you have already borrowed so much. And in 2016, the CAG didn't say as much, but they could have well said, no, see, we had told you you're going the wrong way and this is where you have landed up in big trouble. GSPC is a... We cannot call it just a scam in itself. It's a classic example of how not to do business.
Being very generous about it. The question that remains, the money that they spent, where did it go? Some of it went to the companies which did drilling or supplied the equipment. A lot of it are incidental expenses which seem to have gone up from 16 crore to something like 500 crores. We do not know whose pocket they ended up in. So there is not only mismanagement, financial,
irregularities
is again a weak word, financial misadventures of different kinds, but also big serious questions. If this amount of money is spent, who got the money? You know, as they say, who benefited? So obviously, Gujarat government, GSPC, lost 20,000 crores, which finally, as Paranjoy said just now, was bailed out by ONGC. But this 20,000 crores also went to some suppliers, went to some agencies, and these are something which we still have to figure out. Where did that money go?
You know, some of it is already evident. First, GSPC recklessly borrowed. Secondly, as the then leader of the opposition in the state assembly, Shakti Singh Gohil, pointed out, he actually came up with vouchers, with evidence, which hasn't been refuted, of GSPC splurging. A huge number of questions arise as to where this money went. And I personally believe what happened in GSPC is not just a classic case of how not to do business, as Shubhi pointed out, of the so-called Gujarat model where you make tall claims and you actually deliver a fraction of what you are claiming. But I think it calls for a larger, deeper investigation. And that this kind of question, where did the money go, is really worthy of a detailed investigation by the concerned authorities.
The CBI was called various names, including sort of the house pets and so
caged
on.
Caged parrot,
house pets, if you will. So the investigative agencies today do not seem to have any agency, shall we say, to do some of the investigations we are talking about. But yes, it does raise very important questions. You both of you have talked now about the Gujarat model. Shall we say the Gujarat model has been more about how to make claims, grandiose claims, for the purpose of the media, and then by winning the elections through such grandiose claims or otherwise, then being able to cage the media as well, so that uncomfortable questions are not raised. That's why you both of you have now forced to publish books by yourself, and even in the media, what you are writing, which should have found much greater notice, seems to be sort of in the sidelines.
There has been a total washout as far as this book is concerned in the mainstream media. As far as when gas was, we got some legal notices for good reason, bad reason. There was some mention in the so-called mainstream media. And Sue the Messenger was reviewed in a number of places. As far as this book is concerned, it has been a total washout. People don't want to ask the same questions that we are asking, because by acknowledging the existence of this book, and no, willy-nilly, you would still know anyway, kind of acknowledge know the questions that we are asking. Linking the GSPC disaster, which is a very small thing, and expanding it to the larger so-called Gujarat model, and that's why it's called the grand illusion. As simple as that. And if you care to read the last sentence of the book, if you have read, that is what it is. It's all been a jumla all throughout.
You know, when we had a launch function in Ahmedabad to launch the book, and we had a fairly high profile set of speakers. They all spoke, but you know, there was very little media coverage. I mean, there were TV cameras, but barring a few, very few people reported it. And it must be also mentioned that in the electioneering to the state assembly elections in Gujarat, the story of GSPC, at least as far as the Bharatiya Janata Party is concerned, was conspicuous by its absence. The Congress Party raised the issue, they talked a lot about it, but as far as the BJP is concerned, as far as Prime Minister Narendra Modi is concerned, the BJP President Amit Shah is concerned, as if this company doesn't exist.
Silence, they say, is golden. And here we have 20,000 crore of silence, or the GSPC, shall we call, illusion. Thank you very much, both of you, to be here with us in Newsclick. Newsclick would certainly like to focus on such issues, particularly those which are not being carried by the big business houses which are controlling the media. So that's something that we'll continue to do. Please do keep on writing and do come to our studio to discuss what is not being covered elsewhere.